Hello everybody, my name is Pulkit Chhabra and in this video we'll be discussing the Codeforces round 630 diff 2. We'll be discussing the problems A to E in this series, and in this video we'll be discussing the first problem, which is problem A called exercising walk. So without further ado, let's get to the problem. I'll read it out quickly. And the problem says that there's a cat. Alice has designed an exercising task for exercising walk for her cat. Initially, the cat is located at this LX, Y, and according to her theory, she needs to it needs to move A steps left, B steps right, C steps down, and D steps up. Note that the moves can be performed in any arbitrary order. All right, and Alice, however, is worrying that her cat might get lost. So she hopes that her cat is always in the area x1 to x2 cross y1 to y2, which means that the cat's position at any time should be Yugoma V at any time, then U should be between x1 and x2 and V should be between y1 and y2. All right, also note that the cat can visit the same cell multiple times. All right, so can you help Alice find out if there's a walk satisfying her wishes? So we basically will have to just print yes or no. Yes, if there is at least one such possible walk, and no if there is not, right? So in each test case, we'll be given four integers in the first line, that is A, B, C, D, the number of steps in the left, right, down and up direction. And the second line will consist of six integers, which will be x1, y1, x2, y2, as mentioned in the question. And the ranges are going to be -10^8 to 10^8 for each of the variables. And there is an additional constraint that at least one of these values will be non-zero. And the ABCD are going to be a positive, obviously. And so from this point onwards, I'll be discussing the solution. You can pause the video, think about it if you want to. Yeah, so let's quickly discuss what is required. So basically, the thing is that if we are given a central point, x, y, and this is something x1, and this is something x2 again, and y2 and y1. All right, so it needs to be in this area only, so it should never cross x1 and it should never cross x2 and x1, and similarly for y coordinates. So basically, if we see, we can deal for the x coordinates and y coordinates separately, right? If it is possible to take left and right steps in such a way that it does not exceed the x coordinates, and then we can check if it's possible to take the up and down steps in such a way that it is within the y range, then the answer is yes. If the case is no for any of the two cases, then our answer is no, right? So to check for the x coordinates only, if I talk about, then the best strategy would be to keep alternating the steps, like one step right and then left, then right, then left, then right, then left, until one of the steps is exhausted. Like if we have exhausted our left steps, then we'll simply keep going towards right, or if we have exhausted our right steps, and then we'll be simply going about towards left. Because that way we'll be going as less far as possible, right, from the central point. Otherwise, if we first go towards extreme right and then basically come back taking the left steps, then we would have gone r steps further, but in the earlier case, let's say if r was greater than l, that is the right steps were greater than the left steps, then we would have only gone r minus n steps further, right? So this is the best case scenario in my opinion, and there will be one two more cases that we'll need to cover, because it's possible that we don't even have space to take one step. If we can't even go right once, then there will be a problem, right? Then that case needs to be handled separately. We'll see during the code what are the other cases that need to be handled separately. Let's get to the coding part now. So let me copy the test cases. So basically we'll first need to input the number of test cases, and then basically we'll get ABCD, and ABCD was in the order of A is left, right, down, and then up. So left, right, down, and then up. So let's say left, right, down, and then up. And then basically we were getting x, y, then x1, y1, which means x left and y down, and then the upper value, which is x right and y up, right? So in the same order, I'll take the input x, y, xl, yd, xr, which means x right, and y up, which means y u. All right. So I'll basically need to check the answer for both the cases. I'll initially, you know, initialize my answer with 1 and just cover all the cases in which it's going to be 0. So the first case is if the range is not sufficient in either the left case and or in the right case, that is the x values. It means if r minus l, that is the steps that are going we are going to take towards right in the end, if these steps are greater than you know, x r minus x, or the steps that we are going to take in left, that is l minus r, if this is greater than x minus xl, then our answer is going to be 0, right? Because r minus l will be this number of steps, number of extra steps that we'll take about to the right direction, right? If they are greater than the space that we have, then also no, if the number of steps that we would require to take in the left are greater than the space in the left, then also the answer is going to be no. Similarly for you know, the y also, if up minus down is greater than y up minus y, or down minus up is greater than y minus y down, then also our answer is going to be 0. And now we'll just handle the case in which we discuss that if we don't even have, you know, one place to go, then we'll simply say if xl equals xr, it means that xl is equals to x is equals to xr, right? And left plus right is greater than 0. It means that out of left and right, one of the quantities is you know, non-zero. It means we would have to take at least one step. In this case also our answer is going to be 0. And parallelly for the y case, if yd equals y up, and down plus up is greater than 0, which means there is at least one down or up step to be taken, then also answer is going to be 0, but we don't have the space, right? So the answer is 0. So in this case, I'll just simply say answer equals 1, just print yes and backslash n, else print no and backslash n, right? Let's just try and run it. The test case, the answer for test case is yes, double no, and triple yes. Yes, double no, and triple yes. Yeah, it seems to be the correct one. Let's try submitting. Yeah, it's accepted. I hope the solution is clear to you. Anyway, it's not, you can drop down a comment and I'll try to clear it, and the submission link will also be there in the video description if you want to have a look. Thank you, see you in the next video.